spooky and they're kooky, mysterious and spooky. They're all together kooky, the Addams Family. Their house is a museum where people come to see them. They really are a scream, the Addams Family.
Neat. Sweet. Petite.
So get a witch's shawl on, a broomstick you can crawl on. We're gonna pay a call on the Addams Family. And they're kooky, mysterious and spooky. They're all together kooky, the Addams Family.
Children, it's time for school. Huxley, did you remember to bring your jacket for the bus ride?
Yes, Mom.
You don't seem to be very excited about going to school today, Pugsley.
It's just that today is Friday. Underwear day.
Mwah. Mwah. Remember to hurry home after school, children. Tonight's the big Addams Family reunion.
Oh, boy! The family reunions are always great.
Would you stop slobbering in there? Thank you.
Thank you again for coming today, Mr. Wimbley. And young Mr. Addams apologizes for what he did to your 2x4 collection, don't you, Pugsley?
Oh, yeah.
Now, let's all welcome two very special speakers. The same speakers we had last Friday. Every Friday. Because they're such good friends with the principal, Mr. and Mrs. Norman Meyer.
Thank you, Mrs. Blossom. Good afternoon, class. Now, last week you marveled at our underwear puppet show.
Ew.
This week, we present the exciting world of underwear through the ages.
Why me? Now, would anyone like to take our widow Normie's place and be our helper this week?
No.
Oh.
Forget it, Pugsley Addams. What your pet Gibbon did to our underwear cupcakes last week.
It looks like you're the lucky boy again, son.
Yeah, real lucky.
Oh, come on, NJ. You can do it.
In the beginning, there was prehistoric underwear.
Whoa! Way to go, NJ!
You're holding them upside down, son.
Pardon me.
Better. Then, there was Egyptian underwear. Hold them straight, son. Now, these shorts discovered in the tomb of King Tut are... Norman Jr., you've destroyed a valuable antique.
Sorry, Dad.
Exactly how long have I been telling you about underwear?
Every day of my life.
Aw, poor NJ.
Normina, darling, why don't you play that little underwear ditty you were strumming last night? I have to talk with our son.
Yes, dear. Once upon a time in the chest of drawers lived the underwear man, the underwear man. Once upon a time...
Son, how will you ever take over my business when you don't know your underwear?
Well, maybe it's... maybe I don't...
Come on, son. Tell your old dad. What's bothering you?
Oh, never mind.
Norman Jr., look at me. Okay, underwear is your life. It's in your blood. Come on, son, your destiny is waiting.
57 pairs of underwear on the shelf. 57 pairs of underwear. If one of those pairs should happen to tear, 56 pairs of underwear on the shelf.
I'm doomed.
Hi, Lurch.
Hey, big guy. Thanks, Thing.
Did NJ's parents put on their weekly underwear show?
Yeah.
Are they still mad at your gibbon?
Yeah, but they're even madder at Engine.
A little to the left. There. It just needs your special touch, Uncle Fester.
Coming right up, Morticia.
Oh, perfection.
Wait a minute. I missed something.
What?
Me. I love decorating.
Children, I'm so glad you're home.
We're ready to help with the Addams Family reunion.
Wonderful. You two are in charge of the appetizers. The last time I saw them, they were running loose in the basement. Be a pair of dears and go find them.
Yes, Mother.
Gomez! Oh, Gomez! Dear, you've spent all day in and out of the molten lava. Now, I want you to have a good time, but you don't seem to be enjoying yourself.
I know, Tish, but this seals it. Now that Uncle Fudgy can't make it, I'm really worried. Our family reunion seemed to have lost their old spark. Thank you, Thing.
But didn't you enjoy it when Uncle Goner crashed his blimp into the open-air poetry reading?
Yeah, of course, Tish. But that was 10 years ago. Sure, we've had the occasional scorpion kissing contest, but all in all, it's just not the same.
Oh, well, c'est la vie. Gomez, I said, c'est la vie.
You did? Tish, that's French. Mm. See, Tish? I really am upset. It slowed down my reaction time.
There, there, dear. I'm sure this reunion will be a disaster.
I hope so, dear. I hope so.
Now, dear, don't be too hard on Widow Noemi.
Too hard? Normina, wake up and smell the polycotton blend. We're talking underwear here. No, even more important, Norman wear.
Dear, look!
Oh, don't tell me that Fester's pet vulture's been nesting in our underwear storage room again.
No, it's for Man Jay. He says, I'll never be the Norman Meyer you want me to be. He's run away!
I hope we scraped enough algae off the rafters. You know how much Aunt Ben loves Lurch's dip.
What's that?
Maybe it's a scary monster, and he's gonna burst out of the ground and tear us limb from limb.
Dreamer.
Hi, MJ. What's up?
I've had it with my parents. I've had it with their constant pressure. And most of all, I've had it with all their underwear.
Wow. This sounds serious.
It is. My parents have got my life all figured out. They never let me do what I want. That's why I'm running away from home. I'm going it solo. Mano y mano. You got a spare room?
Are you sure this is what you want to do, NJ? I mean, why would you run away to here?
Because here I can be myself. Man, your family really knows how to live.
Got it!
Sometimes being in Adams can be challenging too, NJ.
Are you kidding? It's 100 times better than being a Norman Meyer. You've got to hide me, please, can you? Huh?
He sounds desperate. Let's bury him in the graveyard.
I think we need to do something a little more subtle, Brain of Flea.
You're right. Come on, NJ. We'll throw you in the quicksand.
Pugsley, allow me to handle this, okay? We know it's not right to keep this from our parents' Thing, but we must help poor NJ out.
Yeah, he's our friend and he's in trouble.
Besides, this idea won't hurt anyone.
It won't? Darn.
Aunt Noggin.
What lovely smiles. It's so nice to see the both of you again.
Yeah, have a great time. I am.
Dear, try to sound a little more excited.
You're right, Tish.
Uncle Cleaver.
Glad to see you, Cleaver, old man. We're gonna have a great time, a whopping good time. This is gonna be the best family reunion yet.
Do you really think so?
Nah, she just told me to say that.
There, there, dear.
Father, we have a surprise for you.
Yeah, it's an Adams you've never met.
Really?
Introducing Mumbles Adams.
A new Adams, you say? Why do they call you Mumbles?
Great story, huh, Dad?
Well, I'm glad you could make it, Mumbles.
Yes!
But as you can see, things are pretty dull around here.
Gomez, quick! Uncle Guzzle's drinking off the floor again.
What do you need from me?
Your drink!
Hey, over here!
We'll give you le grand tour, Cousin Mumbles.
Yeah, let's go! Aha! And just where do you think you're going?
Relax. It's just Granny's psychic checkpoint.
Is something wrong, Granny? No, but I think I'm standing in one of Uncle Guzzle's dreams. Hi, Cousin It. Do you know Cousin Mumbles?
He understands you.
You know what's really scary? I think I understand him, too.
Oh, Mumbles, it's your turn to be kissed by Aunt Goomba. Our aunt. Pucker up. Ew.
It. You simply must introduce me to your friend.
Me too, me too.
Of course, Mumbles Adams. You must be my Uncle Flossie's son.
I could tell by your teeth.
I don't think so! He's obviously from the Cleaver Adams side of the family. The sweaty palms, the furtive look. You like knives, don't you? Don't you? I knew it! Go ahead, take one. I got lots more.
Oh, can I have one? Sorry.
Hold it. Cousin Mumbles is from my side of the family.
And mine?
My side of the family?
No, ours.
They like me. They really like me.
Tan Hut, it's time for a Normanware check.
Check.
Listen closely, Normanware patrollers. We survived the elastic shortage of 88. We protected our extra larges from that herd of marauding goats.
Oh, that was a touchy situation.
But now we face our greatest challenge, finding my little boy. Study these photos carefully. Here's Normie at 2 years and 1 day. Here's Normie at 2 years and 2 days. And look, look, he's wearing his first pair of underwear. I customized them myself.
There, there, Bunky. They'll find our we don't know Normie.
So move out, man!
Yeah.
Well, Tish, that's everyone. Let's get this over with.
I'll show you, first cousin, what's removed!
Tish, what's going on?
I don't know, dear.
Hey, Gomez! Everyone's fighting over Cousin Mumbles. They're wrecking the house!
Oh, dear. Our furniture, our dishes, all ruined. Just like old times.
Hey, caramba. There's hope for this reunion yet. Let's have a look for ourselves, Tish.
You wouldn't want to leave now. We're in the midst of some heavy-duty family bonding.
Hold it, everyone! Wait for me!
I'm gonna
I'll juggle these later. Man, I thought your family knew how to live. But they're a little too weird for me.
And you may not have noticed, but your Uncle Backwash smells kind of funny.
What's wrong, NJ? Don't you like being in Adams?
It's just that I thought my life would be easier as an Adam. But it's not.
Incoming weasel!
Cousin Mumbles, I've got great news. You're invited to sit next to Uncle Frankus and his mother during dinner. What'd he say?
I said, no thanks. I don't want to touch Uncle Cleaver's knives. I don't want any more of Aunt Goomba's kisses. And I especially don't want to sit next to Uncle Frankus or his mother.
Bad move, old boy. Come again?
Help!
Uncle Frankus, stop! This is a family reunion. You just can't chase Cousin Mumbles like that. Here, you forgot your cousin smacker.
This is not working. We'd better do something, Pugsley.
Okay, go, Frankus, go!
I was talking about helping NJ, Einstein.
But being an Adams is even worse. I don't fit in anywhere. I'll never be like anyone else.
What's wrong with that?
Huh? What do you mean?
Yeah, when I grow up, I want to be just like Uncle Boyle.
Thanks, Thing. Think about it, NJ. None of the Adamses are the same, like me. I'm different from any other Adams, but my family still accepts me.
She's my favorite relative.
You can always be an Adams in your heart and still be your own kind of Norman Meyer. Right, Pugsley?
What?
Just talk to your parents and tell them how you feel.
That's it. I've had enough.
NJ, wait!
No, you're right. I've got to stop running away from my problems, like this one.
What have I done?
Wednesday, he'll be all right. Want some coal?
Now you've done it. If you want a piece of NJ Adams, you've got it.
Huh?
Come on, big man, let's get it on. Go ahead, just try to rip me to shreds. I dare you.
That sounds like fun, man, but first I want you to apologize to my mama.
That's all?
He'll be with you in a minute, Uncle Frankus.
It's no use, dear. They can't find our widow Normie anywhere.
He's gone. I was too rough on him. Why, if NJ were to come back, I'd go to work tomorrow without my tie.
Norman!
Well, this is important. I've lost my little Normie, and I'm not very happy.
There, there, dear.
Mom, Dad, you're sharing affection.
Normie! Thank goodness you're back.
Son, we'll try not to be so critical of you in the future.
Like right now, the way you're standing, slumped over with bad posture, and it could ruin your back for life. But I'm not going to say anything. No siree, not me.
Mom, Dad, I didn't mean to make you so upset, but I have something important to tell you. Maybe I can't be just like you want me to be. I said it.
Oh, that's okay, son. We'll try to be a little more
understanding?
That's the word, son.
Wow, Dad, are you really going to work tomorrow without a tie?
Why not? I guess I can be a bit of a rebel myself sometimes.
By George, this is the best reunion yet, and we owe it all to Cousin Mumbles.
Father, Cousin Mumbles is gone.
Gone? But what about the reunion? He was the life of the party.
Dear, the excitement doesn't have to end just because Cousin Mumbles had to leave.
By Jove, you're right, Tish. When was the last time you saw this many happy Adamses, this much fun, or this much broken furniture? I can't wait for next year's reunion.
All right, King. Mother, Father, we have a confession to make about Cousin Mumbles.
Just a minute, my little scourges. A toast to Cousin Mumbles. My vote for Adams of the Year. That is, if he can beat out Uncle Guzzle in the primaries. Now, what was that about Cousin Mumbles?
Nothing, Father.
Yeah, we'll tell you tomorrow. Hey, Gomez, we got the whole brood here. Let's do a mega family dance.
Top floor idea, Fester. How about the Monkey Muffin Bucket Stand?
Nah, we did that last year. How about Loomis Adams' Bat by Jubilee?
Eureka, Fester!
Ah!
Lurch, start the music! Good one, Fester. You sharpened your teeth.